Today's topic is on electrochemistry. In this, we will study the conversion of electrical energy to chemical energy or vice versa. Generally, two cells they are in use. One is the electrochemical cell, in which there is conversion of chemical energy to electrical energy. And second is the electrolytic cell, in which electrical energy is converted to chemical energy. Now, you can see in the diagram, here we have given the electrochemical cell in which there will be conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy. An example is galvanic or voltaic cell. So here in galvanic cell, electricity is produced from a redox reaction, and galvanic cell, it supplies energy that is used to perform work. Common cell is the Daniell cell, in which you can see here zinc rod, which is dipped in zinc sulfate solution, and copper rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution. This portion is acting as an anode and this portion is acting as a cathode. In between is the salt bridge. Now zinc, it will undergo oxidation and it will get converted into Zn plus 2, while copper sulfate solution that will dissociate into Cu plus 2 and sulfate ions. Now electrons will move from zinc towards the copper, and copper, it will take the electrons and it will form what is copper ions. They will form copper. So in this way, a redox reaction is occurring here. So this one, zinc getting converted into Zn plus 2, that is the oxidation half cell, and copper ions getting converted into copper, that is the... Now let us talk about the electrolytic cell. In electrolytic cell, electrical energy will be converted into chemical energy. That is, we will be supplying an energy due to which chemical reactions they will occur. Now here, example is given of electrolytic cell when molten NaCl is electrolyzed. So you can see here, and molten NaCl will dissociate into Na plus and Cl minus. Na plus being positive will move towards negative electrode, that is the cathode here, and Cl minus being negative will move towards the positive electrode, that is anode here. So following reaction will occur at the negative electrode. Na plus will take the electron, giving Na. And at the positive electrode, chloride ions will get converted into chlorine gas. So this is how the electrolytic cell, it will work. Now when we talk about the conductance, they are of two types. One is the metallic conductance, other is the electrolytic conductance. Metallic conductance, they conduct without undergoing any change. Generally the metals, they conduct with the help of electrons, and that is why they are also known as the electronic conductance. Now when we talk about solutions, electrolytes, they can be electrolytes, they can be non-electrolytes. Electrolytes, they dissociate into their respective ions and conduct, while non-electrolytes, they cannot dissociate, so they cannot conduct. And when we talk about electrolytes, they can be strong electrolyte, they dissociate completely into their respective ions, as you can see here, Na plus and Cl minus, or KCl, HCl, H2SO4. And weak electrolytes, they do not dissociate completely, like acetic acid. So when we want to differentiate between the metallic and electrolytic conductor, metallic conductors, as I told you, they conduct electricity without undergoing any change, and they conduct mainly due to the movement of electrons, and they can conduct electricity in any state. While the electrolytic conductance, they first dissociate into ions and then they conduct electricity. And they conduct electricity by movement of ions, and they do not conduct electricity in solid state. They can conduct only in the molten or aqueous state. This was the diagram of electrochemical cell. Now let us see how you are going to represent it. This part was zinc rod, dipped in zinc sulfate solution and copper rod dipped in copper sulfate solution. This side is the anode negative part and this side is the cathode, that is positive part. Now let us see the representation. So you can represent it like this, that is zinc and then one line you will draw, Zn plus 2, and this is for the anode half. So you can draw a vertical line or you can draw a semicolon. And whatever concentration is there, that will be written here in the bracket. So zinc sulfate, this is the anode half, and salt bridge you will show by these two vertical lines, then copper sulfate, aqueous, and copper, that will be the cathode half. So this is the oxidation half cell, while this is the reduction half cell. So you can see here zinc giving you Zn plus 2, salt bridge Cu plus 2 giving you Cu, and these are the concentration. This is the concentration of Zn plus 2 and this is the concentration of Cu plus 2. So this is how the Daniell cell is represented.